हेलो माय डियर स्टूडेंट, गुड मॉर्निंग। लास्ट लेक्चर वी स्टडी डिटेल रॉ मटेरियल यूज्ड इन मैन्युफैक्चर ऑफ सोप। देन टुडे वी डिस्कसिंग टाइप्स ऑफ सोप और डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ सोप। मेनली सोप्स आर क्लासिफाइड इनटू टू टाइप्स, हार्ड सोप एंड सॉफ्ट सोप। देन हार्ड सोप ऑब्टेन फ्रॉम सैचुरेटेड फैटी एसिड एंड कॉस्टिक सोडा और NaOH। देन सॉफ्ट सोप ऑब्टेन फ्रॉम अनसैचुरेटेड फैटी एसिड। अनसैचुरेटेड फैटी एसिड मीन्स फैटी एसिड कंटेनिंग कार्बन कार्बन डबल बॉन्ड, अनसैचुरेटेड फैटी एसिड एंड कॉस्टिक पोटैश, और कॉस्टिक पोटैश इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड द KOH। मेनली दिस आर द टू टाइप्स ऑफ द सोप्स, बट कॉमनली सोप्स आर रिकग्नाइज बेस्ड ऑन पर्पज फॉर विच दे आर यूज्ड, और क्लासिफिकेशन बेस्ड ऑन पर्पज फॉर विच दे आर यूज्ड। देर आर फाइव टाइप्स। फर्स्ट इज द वॉशिंग और लॉन्ड्री सोप। सेकंड टाइप ऑफ सोप इज टॉयलेट सोप। थर्ड टाइप ऑफ सोप मेडिकेटेड सोप। फोर्थ टाइप शेविंग सोप। एंड लास्ट टाइप ऑफ द सोप इज द इंडस्ट्रियल सोप। देन देर आर द फाइव टाइप्स ऑफ सोप। दीज टाइप्स आर बेस्ड ऑन पर्पज फॉर विच दे आर यूज्ड। देन वन बाय वन वी डिस्कसिंग इन डिटेल। फर्स्ट सोप इज द वॉशिंग और लॉन्ड्री सोप। देन वॉट इज मीन बाय लॉन्ड्री सोप? दे आर मेड फ्रॉम चीप ऑयल्स और फैट्स, और बेटर ऑयल्स और फैट्स एंड सोडियम हाइड्रोक्साइड और कॉस्टिक सोडा और NaOH। देन दे कंटेन फ्री अल्कली फिलर्स बिल्डर्स लाइक सोडा ऐश, क्ले एक्सेट्रा। देन दीज आर बिल्डर्स। They are used for sanitization purpose like washing clothes. It is also used for cleaning purposes, cleaning utensils, floors, etc. Then laundry soaps are available as bars, flakes and soap powders. Means washing or laundry soaps containing more quantity of fillers and it is made up from sodium hydroxide and cheap or better oils and fats. Then second type is the toilet soap. In toilet soaps are made from best quality selected material containing 10-50% moisture and some quantity of glycerol is present in toilet soap. In toilet soaps are colored containing expensive perfumes and very few additives. Washing soaps containing more percentage of additive and toilet soap containing less percentage of additives. Then it do not contain fillers and pure and just sufficient alkali is used to avoid any harm to skin and eyes. Means potassium hydroxide alkali used in sufficient quantity. Then transparent soaps are prepared from best quality oil. That is best quality oils are such as coconut oil, castor oil and caustic potash. Caustic potash is also known as the potassium hydroxide. Then you are familiar with transparent soap. Example of transparent soap is the Pears. Therefore toilet soap containing expensive qualities of oils and less percentage of additives. Then Pears is the best example of transparent soap. Then third soap is the medicated soap. Medicated soaps means these soaps are used for medical purposes. They are also toilet soaps containing special additives to give a deodorant and disinfectant effect. Disinfectant and also it act as a antibacterial. Then there is a difference between antibacterial and disinfectant effect. Disinfectant effect means those soaps apply on non-living surfaces is called as the disinfectant effect. An antibacterial, those soaps used for killing the bacteria. Means these medicated soaps have bactericidal activity and germicide activity. Bactericidal means kill the bacteria and germicides means kill the germs. Then for this purpose, this type of soap contain some chemicals such as the phenol, chrysol, xylol and chlorinated phenol. And phenol, for example, Dettol or another medicated soap example is the Medimix soap. Dettol also kill the bacteria as well as germs. Therefore, this is the best example of medicated soap. Then fourth type of the soap is shaving soap. Shaving soaps is mixed soap of sodium and potassium combination. Here laundry or washing soaps containing sodium hydroxide alkali. Toilet soap, medicated soap contain potassium hydroxide alkali, but shaving soap contain mixed, that is sodium and the potassium combination. The salts of fatty acid with ammonia or triethylamine are also used. In last lecture we study monounsaturated triethylamine, disaturated ethylamine, then shaving soap containing triethylamine and ammonia. It contains excess of stearic acid to give lasting lather. This is the shaving soap. And last type of the soap is the industrial soap. Then industrial soap, industries use soap for variety of purposes. It cleaning agent for cleaning industrial machinery, as wetting agent in textile industry. The insoluble calcium and aluminum soaps used to manufacture of waterproof textiles. Zinc and Mg stearate soap is used in face powder. In face powder, zinc and Mg stearate is present. These soaps are made from oils like coconut oil, groundnut oil, olive oil and castor oils. This type of the oils used for preparation of industrial soaps, and industrial soaps used for cleaning purposes of variety of machineries in industries. Then these are the five types of the soaps. Then questions may be asked, write a note on different types of the soaps for 5 marks. The next point in this topic is the cleansing action of soap. Then we study here different types of the soaps, raw material used in the manufacture of soap, and here we study cleansing action of soap. In last lecture we studied cleansing action of soap, that is what is mean by soap. Soap containing two parts, one is the non-polar part and another is the polar part. Here non-polar part is the hydrophobic in nature, means insoluble in water, but polar end of the soap is the hydrophilic in nature, means water soluble part. In soaps, soap molecule classified into two types, water soluble, that is the hydrophilic, and water insoluble, non-polar salt, non-polar tail is the hydrophobic in nature. Then again cleansing action of soap containing 4 steps. The first step is the wetting the surface. Second step is the absorption of detergent. Third is the dispersion of dirt. And fourth one is the prevent redeposition of soap. These are the 4 steps present in cleansing action of soap. Dirt is the soil held to thin film or greasy or oily material on surface, like skin, textiles and other surfaces. Dirt is insoluble in water, so washing with water alone cannot remove using soap or detergent. It can be removed, that is cleansing action of soap, detergent, followed by 4 processes. Here you see the diagram. In diagram, first soiled fabric wetted in soap solution, that is the first step, wetting the surface. Then this diagram shows soiled fabric wetting in the soap solution. Then this diagram containing missiles. And Another diagram show soap coated soil oil drop. Here we study first step in detail, wetting the surface. By using detergent solution, a detergent reduces surface tension and increases spreading and wetting ability of water. So water spreads and penetrates the fabric more easily and reaches the dirt. This is the first step, wetting the surfaces. Then second step, absorption of detergent. The detergent molecule break down greasy layer of dirt by inserting their hydrophobic tails into greasy dirt while keeping their hydrophilic head. Hydrophilic means water soluble head, that is polar end of the soap, exposed to water on agitation. It forms fine droplets called as the micelles. We see in the diagram micelles. Then third step, dispersion of dirt from the surface to wash water. The hydrophilic surface of these micelles get attracted by polar water. This loosens the grip of dirt to the surface, draws them out into wash water. And last cleansing step in cleansing action of soap is the prevent redeposition of dirt. Detergent or special additives used to prevent micelles to folliculate or coalesce into large aggregates to get deposited again on the surface. On repeated rinsing, the micelles are washed away, clearing the surface. This is the action of cleansing action of soap.